So I've been printing for a couple of years now, and I've accumulated a lot of almost empty filament rolls like the ones right here, and they are of course a big waste. So today we're going to install the Creality filament sensor on the Ender 3 V2. Let's go! Reality filament sensor on the Ender 3 V2. It's not really hard, but it's definitely not super straightforward and easier if you can follow a tutorial like this one. What we're going to do actually comes down to installing the sensor and flashing new firmware. Because the Ender 3 in its stock form doesn't know anything about any filament sensor, so we have to tell it. In this tutorial, I will show you how to do this for an Ender 3 V2, but these exact steps might not work on other printers. So if your printer isn't the Ender 3 V2, please proceed with care and do your own research. With that said, let's get started! So the sensor we're using today is the Creality sensor, which you can get from the official website or from AliExpress. The links are down below in the description. If you buy through the link, you will sponsor the channel, so thank you if you do. This is a really simple sensor that uses an end stop switch and an LED to detect whether there is filament inside or not. There are cheaper self-built options out there, but I went with this one because it comes with a complete ready-to-install package. The box contains the bracket with the sensor and the braided connector cable. The box is pretty solid, but inside it, it can just move around and may get damaged during transport, so you might be aware of that. Otherwise, it seems pretty solid and it does the job. Let's move on to installing the sensor. Unfortunately, to install the bracket that came with the sensor, we have to disassemble the whole x-axis of the printer. This is a little unfortunate, but we'll get through it. Let's start off by removing the connectors from the extruder motor, x-axis and end stop. Then in order to remove the x-axis, we will have to remove the top of the printer. Before we can slide up the x-axis, we have to disassemble the extruder and detach the Z-nut from the Z-carriage. Once this is done, you should be able to pull off the complete x-axis. Now we can unhook the belt and remove the carriage. All that rests us to do now is remove the slider wheels and replace the bracket. On the left we have the old bracket without the sensor, and on the right we have the new one with the filament sensor. Now it's time to put it all back together. Alright, so we managed to install the filament sensor. Now we have to open up the casing and install the cable onto the motherboard. Removing the bottom panel takes 4 screws, 1 on top and 3 on the bottom. You can insert the cable into the white 3-pin connector, next to the green connectors for power delivery to the bed and hot end. And while we're here, you also want to write down the version number on the motherboard of your printer. It should say something like V4.2.2 or V4.2.7. This is important for the firmware later in the video. The last thing that rests us to do is routing the cables, closing up the electronics and attaching the cable to the sensor. And just like that, we have installed our filament sensor. Let's move on to the firmware. Now that we have installed the filament sensor, it's time to update our firmware, which will tell the printer how to exactly use the sensor. So the firmware that the Ender 3 and many other printers use is the Marlin firmware, specifically Marlin 2.0. So here we have several options. We could build our own version of Marlin 2.0 from scratch, we could build upon the version provided by Creality, or we could use the improved UI version of Jake Myers. We will be installing the last option, of course. Jake Myers is a 3D printing enthusiast who put a lot of time and effort into building an improved user interface for Marlin 2.0. and has made this public for anyone to use. But wait, it gets even better. Jake also provided pre-built firmware releases with specific features so we don't have to go through the hassle of compiling it ourselves. In Jake's firmware, he even built in the option to enable a filament sensor, which is perfect for our configuration. Now we don't have to go into the firmware itself to adjust it. Instead, we can use the interface to enable it, which is way easier. So let's head over to the PC and get our firmware.
All right, so let's get our firmware. First of all, we're going to need an SD card with at least 1 GB of storage to store our firmware file to then flash it onto our printer. If you have any files on your SD card that you want to keep, I suggest you move them or back them up, because the first thing we're going to do is format this SD card. So we're going to go to formatting and we're going to use the FAT32 file system and a 4 KB allocation size. And let's start formatting. It's going to take a second. All right, it's done already. Then we can open up a new Chrome tab. All right, we have a new Chrome tab, and in the search bar, we can type in github.com. Right, at GitHub, we can search for Gyres, which is the name of Jake Myers on GitHub. Then right here, we can go down to users, and the first one is probably going to be Gyres. He has a green world node profile picture. That way you can recognize him. Right here on Gyres GitHub page, he has 2 repositories, one Marlin and 1 configurations. We're gonna go with the Marlin repository. Right here in the Marlin repository, we can find all the files we would need to build the Gyres UI firmware. We're not going to build it from scratch today because it's really prone to errors and bugs. So we're gonna go with the releases. Jake did already pre-build a lot of firmware versions for us, so we're just gonna pick one of those. Let's head to releases. Right here you get all the different versions. Depending on your printer configuration, you're gonna choose either one of them. Remember when I told you to write down your motherboard's version? Well, that's because it corresponds with the firmware. If your motherboard version is version 4.2.2, then you're going to use this one. If your motherboard version is version 4.2.7, then you're going to use this one. Well, mine was for version 4.2.2, so I'm going to go with this one. Alright, so I have my firmware downloaded. Then I can open up my SD card again. Right here, I got my SD card, and then I'm just going to drag it in there. So I get my SD card ready, and we're now ready to go flash it onto the printer. Alright, so we're here at our 3D printer. Creality has made flashing firmware a lot easier than in the past, so now we only need our SD card with our bin file. Make sure the printer is turned off and insert the SD card. Now we can turn the printer on. If everything goes right, the screen will stay black for a couple of seconds before it will boot up like it normally would. This means that the firmware flash is most likely successful. We can immediately see that there are a couple of changes to the UI thanks to the Gyres UI firmware. And if we go into the info tab of the printer, we can see that we have the Gyres UI firmware installed. Alright, so to enable our filament sensor, we're going into the control tab and look for advanced settings. There we can enable the filament sensor and even configure how much it can keep printing before it has to stop. To test the sensor, I started a print with the filament just through the sensor but not into the extruder. This way I can easily pull it out once the print has started. So as you can see, the sensor triggered and the printer stopped. It's now waiting for me to load new filament. After I load new filament, it will heat back up and start priming until you hit the restart button. As you can see, it works like a charm.
So that was it. I hope you have successfully installed your filament sensor, and maybe even more important, learn how to deal with Marlin and flashing firmware onto a printer. If you like this video, please consider hitting that like button and maybe subscribing. I would greatly appreciate that. And if you have any problems or suggestions, leave them in the comments down below. And as always, have a great day, and I see you in the next one. I'm gonna make it.